On Sunday, the 2nd of March, Firefly's Blue Ghost landed on the moon. This was the first time Firefly has landed on the moon and only the second US-based space startup to land, with Intuitive Machines' Nova C vehicle landing last year. Both companies are contracted by NASA to send more lunar landers to the moon in the future. Descent to the moon. Let's look at Blue Ghost's descent to the moon and the key moments as it made its way to the lunar surface. 1:49 a.m. Central Standard Time, descent orbit insertion confirmation. The descent burn to the moon started at 1:49 a.m. Central Standard Time. This burn put the lunar lander on a trajectory to land in the Mare Crisium region on the near side of the moon. At 2:19 a.m., go for powered descent initiation. At this time, the Firefly team had to decide whether to attempt a landing or stay in orbit for another pass. All systems were working as expected, so the go was given for a powered descent to the moon's surface. This is a critical 9-minute burn using all engines to scrub the horizontal velocity of the lander. The velocity is reduced from 1700 to 40 meters per second. After this burn, the vehicle is in control and will automatically take the necessary actions to land safely and accurately on the moon's surface. This is because there isn't enough time for the Firefly team on Earth to issue commands, as a round trip to the moon at over 2.5 seconds is too long. At 2:22 a.m. Central Standard Time, powered descent initiation begins. The vehicle begins its powered descent to the surface. At this time, D'Souza guidance is used. Think of it as a super smart autopilot that constantly fine-tunes thruster settings to get the lander heading exactly to the target landing site. The lander is reorientated from a horizontal position to a vertical position for landing. The autopilot is constantly on the lookout for hazards, such as rocks, craters, steep ridges, or shadowed areas. 2:32 a.m. Powered descent initiation complete. 10 minutes later, the powered descent is complete. The engines have been shut off and the lander heads towards the target landing site using the RCS thrusters. RCS stands for Reaction Control System. This system is not as powerful as the main engine and is used for fine-tuning the trajectory to ensure an accurate landing. By pulsing these thrusters, the lander reduces its final descent speed to just 1 meter per second just before touchdown. Blue Ghost's navigation system is constantly looking for hazards as the surface approaches. 2:34 a.m. Successful touchdown confirmed. The Blue Ghost lander touches down on the moon's surface. The descent and landing was perfect, with the lander performing flawlessly. This is an amazing feat, considering this is the very first time Firefly has attempted to land on the moon. Post-landing news. Blue Ghost is expected to operate for 2 weeks on the moon's surface while the sun is overhead. As the sun sets, the Blue Ghost lander will lose power, and once its battery is depleted, the mission will be over. Before that happens, Blue Ghost will capture a final sunset photo while it still has energy. Eugene Cernan, an Apollo astronaut, once observed a mysterious glow along the lunar horizon, attributed to dust levitating from the surface due to the sun's influence. If all goes well, the Blue Ghost lunar lander might capture this effect in about 2 weeks, at the time of lunar sunset. Shortly after landing, the first image from the lander was received. In this image, you can see the moon's surface with sun glare on the right. The lander's RCS thrusters can be seen in the top center of the photo. In the next photo, we can see the top deck of the lander with the Earth floating out in space in the distance, with a reflection of the Earth on the solar panels. The instrument on the left is the X-band antenna, and on the right is the Lexi payload. In this next image with the sun behind the vehicle, we can see the Blue Ghost shadow with the Earth in the distance. Surface operations. One of the first things the Firefly team wants to accomplish is the deployment of the high-gain antenna. The vehicle has S-band and X-band antennas. Think of these as S for standard video and X for extra or high-definition video. Once deployed, the X-band antenna will transmit better, high-quality photos and video from the surface. In this short animation, you can see the X-band antenna on the left orientating itself towards the Earth. What's ahead? Over the next 2 weeks, we should see all 10 payloads from NASA become operational and start collecting data or carrying out experiments. The scientific return to NASA is expected in various fields, such as the lunar environment, navigation and positioning, and tech validation. For instance, there is a radiation-tolerant computer system experiment. The Moon doesn't have any appreciable magnetic field, so the solar radiation from the Sun can affect computer systems. Another important experiment tests the stickiness of the lunar regolith, that's the Moon dust. This dust is sharp, tiny, and electrostatic, which means it can stick and cling to surfaces, joints, and scientific instruments. It's also dangerous if breathed in, as it can enter the lungs. There's also a payload to measure the plume of dust as the Blue Ghost lands. In future, much larger and heavier vehicles, such as Starship, will land. It's important to understand what effects that will have on the landing site, so that future lunar infrastructure or bases will not be pelted with ejecta. Okay, that's it for this video. Check out my in-depth video on the Blue Ghost lander. It should be on screen now. Thanks for watching. Be sure to like and subscribe so you'll see our upcoming videos. We make videos every week covering the space industry, with an emphasis on the smaller space startups that aren't covered so well on other channels. See you soon.